Well, hello there, nerdy people. This should be the ultimate nerd boner for every one of you out there that run Linux, but wish they had Windows or wish they had Mac. I have combined, I would say, the best elements of both systems. The macOS theme, the Windows icons, and fun. Here you have it. I call it WinMac. This is what it is. You can see here, if you look at the menu here, this is how it looks. I can have a little... we have like LibreOffice up here, internet, accessories, if you open through now, it's already open. I opened something else instead. You can see up here, you can actually see what themes that I have. I will talk about that later. This is my home folder. We can open up Firefox. This, it looks like this here. We can open up a terminal. So of course this is XFCE, and I'm using those two themes that I just showed you guys here. It's called the White Shore GTK Theme Master, and then Windows 10. There will not be links down below because for some fucking reason the links are on GNOME looks and stuff like that, they tend to change once in a while, and you just have to Google it or search it on GNOME looks or XFCE looks. Just search macOS theme or Windows 10 icons, and there is a little bit of a problem with the icon. You can see here it's not like the network icon up there, and you can see here it's missing some of the icons still, so it's not like 100%, but it's the closest that I could find to the Windows icons that actually work. I'm also using Windows fonts. Oh, that's not it. And you guys can kind of see what it is right here. I am not going to tell you where to find the fonts. I'm not going to tell you how to download them, because fonts are normally copyrighted. Most fonts are normally copyrighted if they are not in your native repo, in your distribution. It means that you can use them for personal use, but you cannot download them, install them, and use them on your distribution. I say this again because I see a lot of people fall into this trap. Don't download third-party fonts that's not already in your distribution repositories, or unless you have read the licenses, because a lot of fonts are free to use for yourself. But the second you put them on a distribution, you're redistributing them, and that's against the law, or against their licenses. See you all later. Bye-bye.